Hi Rishabh.
Hello
again. So today we have a problem from a 46-year-old female. So
yeah.
I'll first lay out the problem. I expect to speak with my husband before we go to sleep. But the moment I start speaking, he dozes off. It puts me off. Even though he may get up again, my mood is off and I shut down myself for some time. But after a few minutes, I become aggressive and become emotional victim. Or become abusive. I couldn't control myself. Being feeling rejected and bad. And again, the argument goes to... So I'm just reading it verbatim, by the way. There may be some grammatical mistakes here. So being feeling rejected and bad. And again, the argument goes to past incidents and doesn't stick to it. It is becoming a vicious cycle. It is taking a toll on me. Like they are 46-year-old. Like we don't know how long they've been married. Let's assume 15 to 18 years, even if, or maybe 20 years. So maybe if initially a few years, she actually hoped that, oh, he'll listen, he'll actually talk. Or maybe he did, in fact, initially.
And he got tired of it.
And then, yeah, he got tired of it, or just relationship probably deteriorated. And now he's not interested. See, there is one trouble that we have to work with limited information. So sometimes we have to assume things. But I hope we'll be able to point out some things which are, let's say, universally helpful.
So maybe we can assume two things here. Maybe husband is doing all things right, and then she is doing things right. And both the cases we can discuss.
Yeah. So in fact, that's pretty much what I'm going to do. See, we have to first identify the root cause here. Where is the problem? Or we can ask, who is making the mistake here? So if I had to make a prediction, I would say most likely... The husband.
Yeah,
most likely. In this case, it seems to be the husband because, see, okay, from husband's point of view, in his defense, let's say, why would a husband not want to talk to his wife and just go to sleep? One reason could be simply that he's anticipating a fight. He's anticipating that she's just going to complain. She's going to say something negative and he probably just wants to go to sleep and relax. So that could be a reason for him. Again, we are not justifying it. We're just trying to understand what could be the reasons behind him not wanting to talk. Because that does happen. If you're anticipating that this conversation is going to lead to a fight, you're just going to avoid it.
Less interested,
yeah,
obviously.
So that could be part of the issue. However, I still think the bigger likelihood of mistake is in husband's domain, because it's actually a very common pattern. And I think it's more common with males than females, because on average, I think females have a higher need to talk also. And there is some studies on this as well. And like per day they talk more. So it's not like I'm not making any baseless stereotypes, because it does exist. There are many males out there who simply just won't share what's going on with them. And they won't share their day. They won't ask any questions. They won't be interested in really knowing about.
I have a friend, a couple friend. The wife complains, and our wife tells me often that he talks like bullet points. And I want stories.
That's a great way to summarize. And by the way, like in all the clients that I have worked with, the problem has never been the other way around. It's, of course, even that sample could be that way. It's a small sample that I've worked with, but still.
Because it's often the wives are...
The wife is the one like who is dissatisfied that they are not engaging enough. And that's what we see here. So it is a little bit of a gender problem as well, probably. That males, on average, they want to talk less. And females, they want to talk more. So that is also what's happening here. So the root cause is also in a male's personality, that guy's personality. Probably he's genuinely that personality. Maybe he has been like that as a kid also, who just didn't want to share much with their parents, because there are people like that. But maybe
it's
not.
It's not a crime to not talk, right?
Yeah. But it could be a crime. But what if he's talking to everyone else,
but not her.
To her, not her. So then, again, we don't know. So, but... with this problem, I did want to point out, highlight this issue, this regular, very common issue where so many women just feel dissatisfied and they feel rejected. And when they bring up something, they just don't get the attention. They just don't get the time.
They feel the partner is not interested in them.
Yeah, interested in them. And it's like it's their word, right? Like if you're not interested in listening to what I'm going through, what's happening with me, like, are we... even in a relationship, like if you don't know what's going on with my life, like how is this relationship? So, okay, with that, I would say that who needs to learn more here? It's probably the husband. And so now if I'm talking to you and like who has asked this question, the 46-year-old female, I would say, what can you do? Probably not much, but of course, I'm going to give you a hopeful answer as well. To start with, you can probably just share this video with them because this is actually a matter of educating your husband, like proper education. I don't mean to say put them down or say you're just this and that. No name calling. They actually need to understand why is it important, and when they don't do it, what's really happening. Maybe you have told him, but maybe not to the depth. Like they don't fully understand what your experience is. So one great way to start would be if you could really just write it down and go in detail about your feelings when he doesn't talk. If you can do that, that's a starting point. If you can create some empathy in them, that this is what I go through. Because trust me, if you do it nicely, they do listen. People, he's not completely logical. I guarantee you, he's not. You have to give their empathy, their logic a chance, but you have to do this nicely. Because what we see in this problem is, the moment it doesn't happen, it shoots up. Like yeah. It starts.
She starts cussing,
and later on, she's actually in a more problem. She has even mentioned that. So, if you're gonna take that approach, where I'm gonna bash you, where I'm gonna thrash you, you are not gonna be successful. That is for sure. Because then he's gonna be even more defensive, right?
Mm.
And by the way, every fight that you have around not talking is actually making it an even more sensitive issue.
Yeah.
So next time he's have one more evidence to now avoid this because, oh, fair, okay, another fight. Who wants that?
More walls in between you.
Yeah, more walls and more data points where he can recall, okay, yeah, I can anticipate it's again going to lead to a fight.
So I think where wives are often stuck is, why do I have to explain him that I need his time? He should realize it on his own.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's where they don't talk about it. They don't want to talk about it.
They want to talk about it. Yeah, very, very interesting point, because sometimes they don't want just the talk. They want it to be initiated by the husband as well.
Exactly. Like,
why don't you feel the need, right?
Why can't he do it?
Why can't he start that? And that's actually a universal problem as well, because like without intent, like what's the use if I have to ask for it?
Yes.
Like what's the use if I have to ask? By the way, there is some use. I'll tell you what. First of all, this expectation that it has to be equally initiated by the husband or to some degree, there is some issue with this, because you are assuming that their need for it, they have to have a robust need for it when they don't. And it really could be simply about his personality, that maybe he just does not need that interaction in his life. Just because he is married does not mean that he'll suddenly want to start sharing, which he probably has not done in years. So you cannot expect that initiation. So you kind of have to make peace with his personality that, listen, I know, I understand that you may not have that need. Like you have to have that starting point. Like I understand that you are like that. It's okay. You want to relax. It takes energy for you, but I have this need too. So let's find a middle ground. But if you do it like, oh, you don't care about me, you are just so selfish, like you never want to talk to me, or you just care about your parents, your friends, and you're just all about work, and I'm nowhere, and I've told you a million times, that's a
very bad. Everyone gets time, just not me.
Yeah, if you take that approach, like not an understanding one, he's going to shut off, and right. He's going to get very defensive, and you're not going to get anywhere with that. So this is why, to that point which you said, you kind of have to accept this bitter truth that he just might have a lot lower need than you. So the initiation part might probably never come. It just might never come. And you work with that reality instead of living in this hope that it was someday he'll show just as much initiative.
Accept your husband's reality as well as express that, you know, I want this, I desire this.
Yeah.
Explain that need as well.
Yeah.
Both of them.
And understand this basic principle, if you accept them well, if you create a nice environment, for them to make efforts, for them to learn something, is the likelihood is much higher. And when you are bashing them and when you are criticizing them, being very, very critical, they have no motivation to learn. They're thinking, go to hell. You know what?
If I'm not doing this, I'd rather not do that too.
Yeah, because you're never going to be happy. Like,
Why
even try? Like, you're just going to be negative. So, that's why if you think that by making those remarks, by cussing the husband, And by bringing up past incidents to put him down, to make him realize, it will fail again and again. And you're actually probably making it worse. You're causing more damage in the process. So the best idea that after sharing this video with him, what you can of course do is, but start with realizing that this could never really happen the way you want, but you can hope for a middle ground. And for that, you have to express your feelings very, 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 very calmly, nicely, and in detail. This is what I go through when you don't do it. And now that I said that this video must be shared to him, so we have to talk to the husband as well. So in case you're listening, we have to address a few points to you as well. Those are, I understand that when you are tired, you sometimes don't want to talk as much, right? And last thing you want to do is push yourself after a hard day's work, right? But in that case, you've gotten your family framework very, very wrong. If you think that you can just be completely lethargic yourself, not give a damn around your family, then it just automatically means that you have put your family very, very secondary. It's not on your priority, because if they're important to you, you have to make effort for them. You have to find energy in you. Maybe work half an hour less so you can talk to your wife half an hour. It's like literally in your list, you can't just hope that with my wife, I have to make no efforts, because that's how it's supposed to be. Like, you take them for granted. I am supposed to be fully be myself, fully relaxed here, because that's my home. No, that's not how it works. A relationship requires work. And that's why you have to put in that work, whether it's listening to the person 10 to 15 minutes, and or whether it's taking the effort to actually share, okay, this is what's happened with me. You have to have those conversations.
I mean, just a 10 to 15 minute of talk in the night would be equal to you talking to, in a day's time, for half an hour.
Yeah. Like, you're married. What do you do?
So yeah, I actually take a lot of effort to, slot my time to talk to my wife. Like, I know that I have to...
It's a new marriage, but yeah, he's still doing it. But
yeah.
Let's just hope that continues for years,
like,
and years.
It's almost
don't let
like,
this go.
Yeah. I won't. Because yeah. It's almost like I have a checklist that I have to talk, I have to, know about her day. So I know I have to do it, and I don't have to sleep before that.
Yeah.
It's almost like
so
this.
Yeah. See, that's really... It comes down to that. It becomes part of your core to-do list. Like, this is part of my... daily routine. Like, you have to,
it's not the end yet if you're not talked to the people around you.
Yeah.
What I do is I often ask her the highlight of the day, so even she goes through her whole day and sees, what was the highlight. It's not about being good highlight or the bad highlight, it's just the highlight. So it becomes a really interesting moment for both of us.
Yeah.
And then when she asks me, I'm like, oh, I have to think, how was my day, how did it go? Yeah. I do something good. So that sharing is really, really gold. I would say.
Yeah. And what I do is, I actually saw this TED talk and I really liked that idea, which was, at the end of the day, before you go to sleep, you ask your girlfriend, okay, what is one thing that you loved about me today? Right?
Mm.
So that's a very interesting question.
I hope the husband doesn't have a girlfriend.
Yeah. Let's not put those thoughts in mind.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, because I'm not married yet, so that's why for me it's girlfriend, he's married now. Now I ask that question, that we ask each other, and then you have to actually think, and you have to think good about each other. That in itself is something very, very important, because otherwise all you're doing is just telling them what you want, what you did wrong, what you want. You forget to actually see the good in the person. Like, what do you actually like? And that needs to be conveyed very, very regularly also. So I include that, like, on top of the conversation where we talk about our day. How was your day? What did you eat? What are you going to do next?
What do you love about me? That's what you ask.
Yeah. What do you love about me? But then I tell her too. So, or I think it's more about that day. What did you love about me today? It's more like that. Tell me something about. So it's more like that. And by the way, it's so much more easier with husband and wife, because they actually live together. And so they can find things. So, yeah. So to the husband, like, we would just say that you really, really need to make that effort. And there are no shortcuts to this. It takes effort. And
definitely it takes effort. It takes awareness that yes, what she's wanting, what your wife is wanting, if you're aware of it, she would be interested in you, in your desires, in your wants as well.
Hmm.
And see, it's not about like 10 minute or 15 minute a day, rather than bundling everything in the weekend, you know, for one, waiting for that one meeting where you'll ask about it. So, it takes away the pressure from the day, that 10 minute or 15 minute conversation.
Yeah, it's actually a stress reducing talk also, yes. Because you can rant also about your day, things that you did not like, and you need that. You need somebody. It's like you are in that moment counselors for one another. It's like,
steam off.
Yeah. You need that actually is a real need. So that's why your wife needs that, and please make sure that you make that time for her. And and by the way, sometimes the conversations will really be boring, and you won't find them interesting. And maybe in your case, that's probably the reason that you don't have much in common. She probably doesn't understand your work, and you guys have not been able to develop a great friendship. I don't know again.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, even though you don't like it, you still kind of have your bare minimum, which is, despite anything, I'll at least make sure I do it for 10 to 15 minutes. Like you take a shower, like you go to work, you get your basic maintenance done, right? Even nobody enjoys working, calling an electrician and getting the work done, but you require that maintenance. So you can think of it as maintenance for your marriage. Like,
exactly.
Even if it isn't very interesting for you, hopefully it becomes with time, but even if it isn't, it's a part to play. Yeah. And this is, if this was not fundamental, I would say, oh, do your own thing. Each couple is different. But it's actually very, very fundamental. That's why there's no way around it. You have to do it. So I think we have discussed.
Exactly. As you are not giving an exception to not do it. That's all right. Like you don't have an exception to not do it or just take it.
This is basically, there are no exceptions to this. Yeah, you have to do it.
That's really needed.
So I think we have given some ideas for both sides. Right. And so I hope it made value, it added value to your life and relationships. I hope you're able to apply this soon. And
yeah, but it's obviously not a complete solution.
Obviously
but
not.
But yet.
Yeah. Because again, we don't know the complete information. We can't give you the, like if I go on a tangent trying to talk about one idea, we need a lot more details. But this is the broad stroke framework for this. And so you can, if you are listening to this and if you like this idea, do let us know in the comments. And by the way, we are taking these problems from the public because we just want to make sure that we really, really address the day-to-day problems at least to some degree on a faster basis. Because earlier again, I used to take a lot of time for one video and I used to have so many queries. So I'm doing this so that I can get to more and more issues. At least to some degree, not too much depth. We can't cover too much depth here, but I think it could be of some.
For that, counseling is needed.
Yeah, for that, of course.
Yeah.
If you want in depth, there are actually two options: public sessions. But again, it's not guaranteed. Better you can, of course, approach us for counseling. If obviously your problems are very, very severe, definitely do reach out. And do, of course, if you want us to cover your problems, do go to the comments.
Yeah, there'll be a link. Fill that form.
And if you're okay for public session, you can also mention that there.
Yeah.
And we'll try to cover that or maybe invite you to talk with us.
Sure.
So with that,
okay,
let's
then.
Close. Okay.
Nice talking to you.
Nice talking to you too. See you again soon. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Videos can give you some good, helpful ideas. But if your life problems are deeply painful and complex, you should go for counseling. You can find someone on your own. Or you can come to us, but please get professional help. To book appointments with a counselor in our team, go to www.sridharlifeschool.com/counsel. We offer parent counseling, relationship counseling, adolescent counseling, and of course, individual counseling for people struggling with depression, anxiety, or other life issues. If for you, getting counseling is difficult for some reason, you can buy our audiobooks. They are very helpful too. You can also buy audio of this video for repeated listening and as a gesture to support me. For audiobooks, go to my website page www.sridharlifeschool.com/audiobooks. If you want more peace, happiness and mental health, do not miss my videos. Subscribe to both our YouTube channels. Sridhar Life School and Sridhar Life School Hindi, and make sure to hit the bell icons, otherwise you won't get notifications. That's how YouTube works. If you find benefit in my videos, or if you're just happy to see me grow, you can support me by making a donation to me. Any amount is welcome. Please go to www.sridharlifeschool.com/donate. Thanks for watching.